Hello friends, today's topic is obesity is good for you. Obesity is a very common problem nowadays. When you get little overweight, you start worrying, oh, what will happen? And when you go to some obesity clinics, they will tell you many things to follow. They will tell you diet chart, this you should eat, this you should not eat, then whole working style, ki, this much our swimming, this much our gym. So this is all what they suggest, and they want to change whole your lifestyle in few days. And you get more stressed. How will I follow all this? So that's why I kept the topic of this video. So that by seeing topic, at least you will get relaxed for some time. When you are having BMI up to 25 to 30, you are still able to control very easily by changing in lifestyle. Above 30, you need to be a little more serious because now it is a disease. So what is BMI? BMI is body mass index. How you can measure BMI? You can take person's weight in kg and you can divide it with person's height in meter square. So square of person's height you divide. So whatever result you get, the weight divided by the height in meters square of that height, and the result is your BMI. See, there are many names of obesity in different languages. In Hindi they will say motapa, in Ayurveda they say sthalya, again the Sanskrit word, but the meaning is same. In normal weight, if you get more weight, then, but what is normal weight? There are different concepts of normal weight in different cultures. So that's why I said, do not worry too much when you consider yourself obese or somebody say you are getting obese. First, try to understand what are the causes of this overweight. See, there can be any causes. Mainly we understand it is a lifestyle disorder. By changing food and lifestyle, one can decrease weight. It's true. The main cause we considered is intake of energy dense food like carbohydrate, fat, increase the weight. Other cause is overeating, irregular food habits, also one of the cause. But apart from them, there are many other causes. Like if you are having genetic or hereditary problem of obesity, so it is not your fault. Okay. Second thing, if you have undergone some medical surgery, after surgery also some people gain the weight. Third thing is endocrinal problems. If you are having thyroid, hypothyroidism, then also you can gain weight. And there are some psychological factors also. If you are depressed or anxiety is there in life, so you will eat more and you will work less. So that lethargic lifestyle because of psychological factors also. So then you need not to treat obesity first. You need to treat other causes. If you are having endocrine problem, you will treat first that. Then otherwise surgery problem, then you have to follow according to. If you are taking some hormone pills, that also can cause you the overweight. So it is not only your eating or lifestyle, sometimes other causes also. In Ayurveda, we considered like kapha body type. There are 7 body types in Ayurveda. So kapha body type people also easily gain the weight. So you have to first diagnose yourself ki what is the key issues. And accordingly, you focus on the problem. So don't jump directly on the heavy suggestions of many obesity treatment clinic. It is their business. They will bump you with many things. Eat this, eat not, this work, this gym, this activity, this much hours walk, etc. But you have to first see the root cause. Then first you have to see how much you can start. See, in world, whole world, obesity nowadays is a big problem. So it is not only you are suffering. Okay, there are many people, but causes are different. In India, more than 10 million cases per year of obesity comes. This is a research. And there is other research in America, 1 in 5 children, means among 5, 1 child is overweight. So this is considered as an epidemic disease in USA. So in the same way, many developed and developing both countries are having this issue. But for this problem, there is no single cause. There are variety of causes. That's why we consider obesity in Ayurveda as a lifestyle disorder. So first thing is stop worrying too much that you are too much obese. Yeah, you have to be serious. Why? Because when you are overweight, then there are higher risk for getting diseases like type 2 diabetes, heart disease, cancer, etc. But there is no 100% proof all obesity people will get this disease. And there are some other exceptions also. So first you listen the whole video, so you will get the clear idea. So first thing I will say, it is easily controllable, manageable by eating habits and lifestyle change. So if you change food and lifestyle, 80-85 kg weight easily be manageable without any medicine at all. But if you are above 100 kg, yeah, you need to be more serious, but not tensed. You have to be serious. So what you can do to manage overweight? Or how, if you are not overweight, how you can prevent obesity? So these both the questions we will solve here. We will tell you the 7 steps, 7 things which can ease your stress about obesity. First thing is, start with tiny steps. See, if you want to do too much changes just to reduce weight in your life, so your life will not be easy for you. So don't start immediately with 3 hours exercise, 4 hours swimming. No, relax. Start with tiny steps. Like if first day you walk 10 steps, next day you increase to 20 steps. Start tiny steps, walking every day, especially after dinner you must walk every day. So start with your own house. No need to go to garden. First start 15-20 steps at your house, then increase steps, then slowly go to 1 kilometer, then you can go to garden. And or morning walk, if you have time in morning, go for morning walk. But start with tiny steps. Initially, if you are above 100 kg, you will not be able to do brisk walk, so start with normal walk, then slowly your stamina will increase. And then you can start the brisk walk. So don't worry ki I'm not able to walk brisk walk. No, it's okay. Start with first step, 10 steps, 20 steps, and go to longer walk, and then turn it into the brisk walk. So slowly increase the stamina. This will not give you stress, but this will give time your body to accept the change. Okay. Second thing is, eat sufficient amount of food, but that food should be of quality food. Quality means what? Which is helpful for you to control the weight. Like morning, early morning, we start with hot water. Whatever season it is, even if it is hot summer, but you drink, start with one glass of hot water, increased it four glass slowly in 6 months. So every day early morning, hot water. When you take the breakfast, include more fiber in the breakfast, like raisins are good, walnut is very good, the sprouts are very good. Some fruit juices you can keep in the breakfast. Brown bread and butter also a normal breakfast you can take. With it you can have some herbal tea if it is winter season, and summer season then fruit juice. So this normal breakfast you can have. Second thing, when you go for the lunch, lunch can be the normal rice, legumes. In rice, you can put the half and a spoon clarified butter, ghee. It is very good for metabolism, digestion, but that should be pure. Cow's ghee we consider in Ayurveda as the best for digestion, metabolism. So rice, legumes, buttermilk. So we are not suggesting you the curd, but buttermilk is very good for digestion and also light. For dinner, if you go, you can have the boiled vegetable or the soups of dal, moong dal, etc. So these three meals you can plan according to availability, but the nature of food should be less carbs, balanced protein and little bit of fat, which is clarified butter. Fat means not cheese, we are saying. The clarified butter is different in nature. It helps in metabolism. So that you take in the night after dinner. As I said, the walk you are going to do is tiny steps, 10 steps, 20 steps. After the dinner, 2 hour after dinner, again before sleep, you take the hot water, one glass of hot water. So whatever excess fat you have taken, that will melt. Now we come, the third important thing is lifestyle. What changes one can do in lifestyle? See, as I mentioned before, do not do drastic changes. Just because you are tensed by your overweight, suddenly you are doing 6 hours of working, like 2 hours gym, 2 hours swimming and 2 hours walk. Don't start with too much exercises immediately. Because drastic change may lose some weight, but in long term it will harm your body. If you leave the gym 2 hours every day or working and immediately you leave after a few months, again your body will get some issues. Or if you are doing some swimming for 2 hours and you think you will lose weight, but it can be vice versa. I will tell you my own experience. I am Kapha body type, and as you know, I mentioned Kapha body type is considered as a naturally overweight from childhood. They are having good healthy body. So I used to do yogasanas from my teenage. So I maintained my health even though I was Kapha body type, but it was good. But being a doctor, after 40 years, my continuous sitting work and sometimes traveling for giving lectures, medical camps, so could not maintain that food. So I increased little weight after 40 years of age. So I thought, I left the swimming many years before, I must start again. And I started 1 hour, 2 hour swimming. What happened? I used to feel more hungry after the swimming. And people say, it is easy to say ki you should not eat 2 hours after the swimming, that will burn your fat. But one who is practicing, they know how much digestive fire is strong after the swimming. And after starting swimming, I increased the weight 4 kgs. So sometimes some exercises do not suit to your body type or your lifestyle. So that's why I don't do a drastic changes. What I did is later on I stopped swimming. I usually started my natural yoga routine, which I used to do from my teenage. and just started having carbohydrate only once a day, morning nuts, sprouts and fruits, and the night again the protein only, and walk anyway I used to do after dinner walk, so that was there every day. So automatically, naturally, I reduce 5 kg. I increase 4 kg by swimming, but just from these tiny steps, I myself. So it is not I am telling you the theoretical thing. In everybody's life, there is a very busy schedule nowadays. So sometimes we gain weight. So we can start like this. Another reason I will tell you. Because I was doing yoga from my childhood, so my flexibility of body was, even the overweight, I was good in flexibility of my spine. Why it is happened? Because that yoga I have not left. So don't worry you are having overweight, but if you are doing some exercises maintaining the flexibility of body, that will help you to maintain your other thing, cholesterol, blood pressure, normal. So you can maintain health with these normal things which I mentioned. Suppose you have to eat anything in between the meals. You can take nariyal pani or green tea or some dry fruits like I said walnut or raisins or pistas, almonds, whatever you prefer, little bit quantity you keep with you. So in between the three meals, if you feel hungry, don't take junk food or fast food. Prefer this type of natural options. There are other options in the early morning. If you don't drink herbal tea, then the cumin water, cumin seeds, you can boil. The one night before you soak in water, next day early morning you boil, and that boiled water of cumin seed you can take empty stomach. The other option is hot water with lemon and honey. 1 glass of hot water, 1 spoon lemon juice and 1 spoon honey. But some people are allergic to lemon, and sometimes the combination of lemon and honey is not suitable to all. So you can just take only honey with hot water, 1 glass of hot water, 2 spoons of honey. This will be very, very useful. For knowing the detail about what you should eat according to your body type, we have already uploaded another video. Title is Foods According to Your Body Type. So you please watch that video, link we have given in the below description. Now we come to the fourth point, and fourth point is try to be less lethargic in daily routine. Suppose if you are feeling like sitting while you are working in office, so try to stand for more time instead of sitting. Even if body want to sit, you try to do work by standing. And suppose your body want you to sleep and watch TV, so try to sit for long time instead of lying down. So when we have little overweight, our body demands more lethargic lifestyle, but you do not fulfill the demand of the body. Especially for that, you need to control your mind. So what you should do is to control your mind. Sit straight and do some pranayama. Pranayama is a breathing exercise mentioned in yoga. You can learn pranayama even from any yoga teacher or online you can see. So do some pranayama. It will increase your vital capacity and control over the mind. So like that you can control what demand of the body you should fulfill or what demand you should say no. Okay. Fifth thing we come is do not focus too much on overweight. Instead, you focus more on your profession or increasing your other abilities. What happens if you think all the time about obesity? It will not help you to decrease weight. But if you focus more on your profession, and if you get success in your profession, that success will give you enthusiasm and more energy to help you in maintaining your weight. Because you see, there are many successful businessmen, singers, and other people in the society who are having overweight, but people like them, people love them because they are good at their profession. They are a good singer, they are a good businessman, they are a good social worker. So body shape doesn't matter all the time. Also matters is how much you are working in other field of life. So do not think too much, I am overweight. This thinking will not help you to decrease weight. Instead, increase your other abilities. Do some good work in your own profession. It will help you indirectly to decrease or control your weight. The sixth point, if we come, if you spend some time of your day in other hobbies like music, painting, cycling, or reading some other book other than your profession, that will also help you to reduce weight. How? Because most of the diseases are psychosomatic, and obesity is also one of them. So if you are having a proper relaxation of mind and you will not depressed or too much worried about your obesity, you will automatically lose the weight. Because when you are too much stressed, you start eating more out of stress. So when you turn your some focus to your other hobbies like music, painting, reading books, any other relaxation work for mind other than your profession, it also helps you to control your weight. A definition of health according to Ayurveda mentioned by Sushrut Sahita, the definition is in Sanskrit, but the meaning of that definition or essence of that definition is, apart from physical health, if a person is having the happiness of mind, senses and soul, that is also important to be considered as healthy. Okay, the Sanskrit shloka is sam dosha sam agnishcha sam dhatu malak kriya prasannatme indriya mana swastham it abhidhiyate. So they are talking equilibrium of doshas, equilibrium of bodily fires, equilibrium of vital tissues, equilibrium of assimilation and elimination of digested food, and also the happiness of mind, senses and soul. These all, if you are having, then you are healthy. Okay, so this definition is accepted by WHO also. World Health Organization also approves this definition, because happiness of mind is also important to be considered as healthy. So that's why I started with don't worry about obesity. So because too much you are worrying, like I come to now the seventh thing, if you are worrying too much about weight, then your energy will divert. So instead of worrying, relax your mind. This is the seventh point. Relax your mind with help of meditation. You can learn some meditation techniques. There are many people in the world who are having obesity, but they are living a long life, and there are many thin people who are having underweight or normal weight also dies early because of other diseases. So be thankful to God that you are alive and able to move your body, and use that gift of God and move your body. Start with tiny steps. Just to keep your morale up, I will tell you one thing. There are many countries in the world, especially the Caribbean countries, where obesity is considered as good. Also, as I said before, in Ayurveda, kapha body type people who are having little overweight in comparison to other body types like vata body type and pitta body type, those kapha body type people are considered to be have more immunity and more long life than other normal body type, medium body type pitta and the thin body type vata people. If you do not know what is your body type, please watch our other video, Do You Know Your Body Type? The link is given in description. So these are the 7 things we have mentioned which you can do to manage your overweight or to avoid the obesity in future. If you have any questions regarding this topic, please ask us. If any suggestion, you are most welcome. We will follow your suggestion, and if you have any other topic of your interest, we will make video on that if you tell us that topic. We have some health related books. The list of books is given in the description. Other videos from our channel, that list is also given in the description. So see you in the next video. Till then, bye bye.